In one sense, we fall united and stand divided.
For the best liberty-oriented talk 24/7, visit lrn.fm.
We have seen how Ireland was not conquered until she was united, how the same was true of the ill-fated factions that gathered against Caesar under Vercingetorix. We have seen how Yugoslavia, with its forward convention of defensive, was reduced for the loss of only 200s of German soldiers in 1941, but subsequently perhaps half reconquered in 1943 through the use of initially disorganized guerrillas, and in the 1950s unintruded upon by a hostile but wary Marshal Stalin. Lastly, and perhaps most disgracefully, how the lawfully constituted French rulership actively conspired against its own population to place French manhood into the service of the Nazis, when they could have easily evacuated abroad, as nearly all the other defeated governments did, and there undertaken the reduction of the German regime from Algeria. Perhaps these, like the Pashtuns, have taught us that in one sense we fall united and stand divided. They may be known for many bad things, but they will perhaps never be known for being easily conquered and then collaborative with an occupier. The concentration of power is sufficiently great so as to provide an option of imposing self-surrender or stand down is a concentration too great. And it may be that a well-trained, highly equipped body of organized combatants, as the French military was, if led in any detail by a single commander-in-chief or even system, is a dramatically inferior experience, expedient when compared to untrained but decentralized resistors. Imagine a water-like and formless mass of local humanity, each individual able to choose if they wish from an anonymously sourced and blockchainable list of preferably non-lethal, physically painless targets, to be struck with demolitions, with electronic instructions, with low-tech drones, perhaps even with face pies. For an authoritarian figure who fears public humiliations and indignities above nearly all other things, could they, rather than bloodshed, become the means of its vanquishment? All friends of the accosted region could contribute to the list. Officially sanctioned objectives could be detailed, or perhaps only outlined in constructive vagueness. All friends, restraints could be articulated, though perhaps not well enforced, against excess. These could be voted up and down by the chain's community, which could easily be limited by user agreement and expulsion regimen to those who renounce the impairment of bystanders. False flags attempted by the intruding state-level actors would likely, without much effort, be shown unsanctioned by the pseudonymous but public record of planning. Outside, a world simultaneously enraged and entertained would be drawn to spectate the unfolding drama of resistance. Much as the world spectated the resistance at Catalonia in 2017, as an off-the-cuff example. Each unpaid soldier, neo-guerrilla, or expedient, untroubling on their own to an aggressor, might in aggregate become formidable and wildly unpredictable obstacles to dominance. An unspoken facet of the proposals thus far outlined is the unusual preponderance of individual, not just group action and latitude.
Can't do that.
Federal agents on the streets of Keene, New Hampshire. They're investigating reports of an unlicensed radio station said to be broadcasting LRN.FM. So why all the fuss? What is LRN.FM? Well, it's probably not something these agents want you to listen to. It's a 24-hour news talk broadcast, all pro-liberty. A true authoritarian free zone. Tune in at LRN.FM to listen or broadcast their signal. LRN.FM. Feds don't want you to hear them.